In a previous video on this channel, I actually showed you how to set up and configure JavaFX for JDK version 11. Now that we've done that, I want to go through the process now and show you how to configure a new project to use the global setup of JavaFX that we set up again for JDK 11. So let's make a start on that, and we're going to be using the IntelliJ IDEA IDE. So let's get started. So IntelliJ has got a plugin that supports JavaFX applications. When you install IntelliJ, the plugin was installed and enabled by default. So we're going to go ahead and use that in this project. So you click on Create New Project as you normally would. And you notice the option here to the left, you've probably seen that before. We've got Java, which we've used traditionally, but there's also this JavaFX. Make sure your project SDK is set to 11 in this case. Click on Next. We need to define a name. So I'm going to call this one Hello World FX. So effectively, we're going to be creating our first Hello World project, but using JavaFX. I'm going to click on Finish now and create the project. Now, click over to Main, you'll see right away that there's some errors. So we've got the errors, and that's because the JavaFX library is now no longer part of the JDK. So we need to actually configure it and set it up so that the global library we've defined is used for this project. So you'll need to do the following steps every time you create a new JavaFX project if you're running JDK 11. The first things first, we want to click on the project, right-click and select Open Module Settings. Come up to Project. We want to firstly check the project SDK is correctly configured, 11 in my case. The project language level needs to be configured the same as the project SDK, so the same number. In the case of 11, JDK 11, obviously I'm selecting 11. And by doing that, then if you come over to modules, you should then find that, because we're using the project default, that that's now also set to version 11. The next step we also need to do is go to global libraries. Then you need to right click here. We need to click on add to modules. So what that's doing is adding this module that we've defined, this global module. We're telling IntelliJ that we want to use that in this particular IntelliJ project. So I click on that. So once only set up, and it confirms that it's going to be added to the selected modules, which in this case is the name of our project. Click OK. Click OK again. Now you can see that that has actually fixed some of the import errors. We're now no longer getting any errors. But you'll find that if we go to run this now, just expand this out so we can see a little bit better, we will find that we'll get an error. So I'll click on Run. We've got an error there. JavaFX runtime components are missing. Basically, what we've done so far is we've added the global library to our JDK 11 application, but at this stage, it's not working because we need to configure it so that it works when we're running the application as well. So what we need to do to actually fix this is we need to add a module-info.java file so that we've defined the JavaFX controls so that they'll actually work. And the way we do that is we right-click the source folder, noting that I'm not clicking on the package name, I'm clicking on at source level, right-click, select new. We need to select module-info.java, and that should open up a little file like this. And by the way, if you don't see the option here, when you right-click and select new, if you don't see an option there, we won't see module info there now because you've already created it. But prior to that, actually what I'll do is just undo it just to show you. So I'm going to cancel that. Right-click again, new. So if you don't see this module-info.java package, what that means is you haven't correctly configured in project the project language level. So 11 is either not set there or set there, because once you do that, that option should come up for you automatically. So I'm going to go ahead and create that file again, module-info.java. And what we now need to do is add a few commands here so that JavaFX will work. The first one I'm going to type is requires JavaFX dot, and it's going to be fxml. That's number one. And the second one requires JavaFX dot controls. Then the last line we need to add then is opens. We're going to go sample. Sample is the name that we've defined here, basically the package name. So we're specifying that there. At that point, we will now find that this application will work for JDK 11. So let's actually give that a test run. And you can see now we've got basically a GUI interface. There's no controls on it at this stage, and that's normal because we haven't added any controls to the application yet. Bottom line is that it's now working. We've correctly configured the JavaFX library, the global library. We've configured it and added it to this project. We've also added the module-info.java file. So at this point in time, it's now working under JDK 11. All right, so thanks for watching. If you've got questions, leave a comment. If you're ready for the next programming specific video, click on the link up here in the top left-hand corner of your screen. To look at non-coding programming related questions, click on the link down the bottom left-hand corner of your screen. Feel free to subscribe by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you in another video.